1924, there were three banks that pulled together some money to create what was known as the Sangamon County Foundation. And then for about almost 80 years, it was really kind of a sleepy organization under the radar that not many people had heard about. It was in 2002 where we really had a rebirth of the organization, converted from a private foundation and became a community foundation in 2002. And back then they just handed what was then a really young guy a box with some documents in it and said, there you go, kid, let's see what we can do. And I would really relied on the reputations of the good people who were on the board to get the word out, to start charging ahead and figuring out how to build up philanthropic resources for the community.
I can remember the first retreat, and we talked about getting our assets to $10 million. And I walked out of there thinking, these people are nuts. We were so far from that at the time. Once it started to get some name in the community, I think the people who think of philanthropy thought this is the place to be.
The mission of the foundation is connecting people who care with causes that matter. I think that's one of the greatest simple mission statements I've ever heard, because that's really what we do. Lots of people, almost everyone, would like to help in some way, but the challenge is finding good and effective ways to help and to get engaged.
I think the greatest thing that the Community Foundation has done is become a convener and a collaborator, and because of that, then it's put us on the map for people setting up funds and groups setting up funds, and we have some amazing fun stories, whether it's a scholarship fund in memory of a coach, or the King's Daughters Fund. They took their endowment, brought it over, and they've done some amazing giving, whether it's the Young Philanthropists or the Women for Women, which is a group of women who came together on their own. We didn't even convene that group. I think Karen Hissera, former mayor, kind of called the ball and brought all these people together, all these women, and they've done some amazing things. So the stories are just amazing. That's what our Community Foundation has become. It's a whole bunch of funds that represent what people care about.
They have effectively established themselves as a place that people can come to when they want to make an impact in the community. But they're also known throughout the community to nonprofits and to people who benefit from nonprofits as a place that you can go for support, a place that you can go if your organization is in need, or a place that you can go if your organization has an amazing concept that you want to institute and get funding for.
They're always seeking to provide a solution or seeking to get you to a solution. And we know they can't be the end all or the solution to every situation or challenge, but they're always seeking to put partnerships together so that you might be able to receive the right resources or connect with the right group to get you towards your expected end. They're concerned with the entire community and not just a certain sector of town or a certain hierarchy of folks, but they're always, and as much work that they've already done, you could call them successful, almost over the top already, but they never seem to rest on their laurels. They're always seeking a place that they can help or pitch in somewhere else as well. So I think that's a hallmark of the Community Foundation here in town, that they're always seeking to do just a little bit more. So that's important.
Through the grant process and through the reporting process, we get to see actually the work that is done in the community. And I think that's really powerful for deciding where our community needs to head for next steps. So it is not just throwing money at the problem, but a lot of heavy duty lifting on the research side of figuring out and talking to community members about what the needs are.
They were tough on us, and they made sure that they had the best bang for the dollar. And so when we would submit our reports, they would often come back to us and say, well, I want to know more about this, or you need to show me more about that. And so, I mean, that's the other benefit Community Foundation provides, which is, you know, really making sure that they are responsible stewards of their funding. Not only can you trust, you often have a say in determining whether, in finding out whether that dollar that you gave had a good payoff.
You know, connecting people who care with causes that matter. And that's what it is. It lets things happen in our community based on either group decisions or on individual decisions. The idea that we're helping people and we have an individual opportunity to do this is just phenomenal. When we were meeting in small rooms, trying to plan community works, other opportunities, we had no idea it would come this far, this fast.
We started with under $1 million. Now we're around $28 million in assets. We now give away more each year than we had in total assets in the beginning. So that's, you know, really rewarding to think of the dollars that have been created and distributed, and just knowing that they're all going to do some level of good. But I think what I'm probably the most proud of for the Community Foundation is how we've just gotten more and more people recruited to be part of this. And the people that are behind either creation of the funds with their own generosity or thinking of the grant recipients who do such fine work in the community to help people or the causes that they support, that's really rewarding work. You know, we and staff come to get paid to do this stuff. But we have so many volunteers, hundreds of people each year that are on committees that really give thoughtful consideration of how to distribute funds or come to us and say, you know, I'm really thinking of doing something impactful with our philanthropy. John, what do you think? I mean, that's a real privilege to get involved with those conversations. So I think what I'm the most proud of is the people that we're associated with, that we, again, borrow their reputations to get our mission fulfilled. And they don't have to do this. They do it because they want to, because they in their life want to see this a better community.
Anybody can be a philanthropist. It isn't a matter of how much money you have. And anyone can be a philanthropist.
I constantly challenge John on approximately a 10-day basis as to how many more accounts or funds he's going to have established. And I won't mention the numbers I challenge him, but they are always a big reach.
Sky high. And we'll make it.
And we'll make it.
I'm absolutely convinced that there's no limit to what can be done.